G'day guys, it's Scorch here with another How to Build, and today we are not going to be building this ONI building that you've all been requesting me to build. We're going to get to this, but it's not going to be in today's How to Build, but we're going to start setting up to build for this. Because how a lot of you want this, a lot of you want this building, but a lot of you want this set up like how I've got it here connected onto the space tether. So, this comes a little problem. We've already built the space tether before as a how to build, so we kind of need to get this in between stuff done first before we can do that. So we're gonna have to start building backwards. So today what we're gonna do is we're gonna build the bridge section, and we're gonna try to get this this little room here done. That way we can start laying the foundation. Well, we will lay the foundation for this to be built, hopefully, next week. Or start building it next week. So, it's not like I'm not building this today, but we're laying the foundation for this to be built. So, it's kind of we're building it, but we're not. So, with that said and done, let's start building ourselves a bridge and a ONI waiting room thing for a space tether. To the blank world! Alright, so here we are back in the blank world where we built the space tether all that money many months ago. And this one looks like crap with the regular glass. I switched mine out with black stained glass because I think that looks a lot better. It definitely suits ONI's dark, creepy purposes. So what we're going to need is... we're going to need stone bricks. Stone brick stairs, regular slab, some black wall. Now you can use any stained glass here. I'm going to use light blue because light blue is pretty cool. Now if you did end up building this sort of structure here in the tutorial, you know, good for you. I'm just going to smash this roof ceiling part out. If you didn't, well, let's just go for a bit of a quick run through, shall we? After I finish destroying this. I mean, why did I put stone brick there? What was I thinking? Why is there stone brick there? What were you guys doing to me? And I did forget one last thing. I mean, come on. How could I forget this? Potion of swiftness. Alright. So, from the original space tether, where we have this little thing here at the front, the first block down that comes level with, like, the rest of it, the roof, I'm just going to go to my stained glass, and all I want is just a row of 7. So, we're going to put one there, and then 3 each side. Now, with the bridge, you can make it as long as you want. I suppose I should probably actually go and count to see how much space you're going to need for the actual building and the waiting room. Future me! Post that down in the video. Post the dimensions of the building and the waiting room so that way people know how far to build their bridge. What's the bet future me forgets this? So yeah, just build it as long as you want. I'm gonna need to go past that other space tether. That's the tether of tethers. Alright, so you get the point there, so we want all 7 rows to like go that far. So once you've done that, you're just gonna need to do 3 rows of steps, which I've already done there. So let's just keep on going on an incline down. Now, under the third row, you can swap to a different stained glass if you want. I'm just going to keep it to the light blue because I think it looks pretty cool. And then you can just do a row of that. Then under that, you want to do 2 rows of stone bricks and then 1 row of upside down stairs. Now, with your upside down stairs, I had my last one here on an angle, so that way it curves in to these lot of stairs, as you can see there. Wow, I can't believe actually how far ahead I planned this. So from there, like once you do that both sides, which you can see I've clearly done that, on the inside, what you can do is you can swap to your stone slab, which I've already got in my hand, and you'll want to go to your first row of stone bricks here that are underneath the glass. Look at the bottom part, because you'll want to do three rows. And you can do that either side. Now, the reason that there's a gap here in between both this bottom row and the row of slabs is if for some reason you're a crazy redstone nutter like I am, you can actually use this space to put in like redstone lamps. I'm just going to use this as an example. So you can go boosh, boosh. Boosh, boosh, boosh. And you can just do that all the way along. So that way you've got like some lights in the tunnel. If you're not confident with redstone, then you can just put in glowstone. We'll just cover that up quickly. Now I did my lamps every seven blocks. So let's just use this as an example. I'll use glowstone. So I'd have one there, and then go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On the eighth one, smash that out and put, well, glowstone or redstone, like I said, whatever you use. I used redstone, because I have it all running on a lever. Because levers are cool. Alright, and again, just like everything else, everything can just be extended for as long as you want, or as long as you need. Hope, like I said, hopefully future me put in the dimensions of the other two buildings, that way you can build your bridge long enough. So I might just quickly do one side here just to show you guys how to do it, and then I'll go for a quick pause and do the other side. I think you guys have kind of got the gist of it anyway. If you do want to make things look a little bit fancy, or fancier, what you can do is with your steps, once you've placed like your proper on the outside here, and you've done your next row, you can just come inside here and do an upside down row like that. What is this daytime cycle stuff? Who hasn't changed this? I bet you there's weather cycle on as well. Shows how long I've been in this world. Come on. Huh. This has got to be the most boringest video how to build tutorial I think I've ever done. All the dislikes are happening now, because everyone's like, "Ah, you dick, we wanted that ONI building." Alright, so just underneath, all I've done is just one row of upside down stairs. And then after that, it's just 11 across of a stone brick. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And again, you just extend that as far as you want and then mirror it around. But what we want to do in the middle here is with a black wall, we want to put this on the level that's below the slabs and is the same level as our lights. We just want to do 5 across of that, like so, and this will also go the same length as your bridge. Now the reason for this is I actually use this as a road. So, potion Y. Slurp it down. So we'll just quickly do this. Hey, actually, this is a good reminder. For those that actually watched the Mega City how to build, when I actually built the roads and streets and stuff like that, this is actually the same way I do this. Or do that. So what we'll need is to... you don't need to need any block specific. I use bricks because I like it. You'll need a button. A detector rail. Regular rail, powered rail, oh for God's sake, and obviously a minecart. I'm just going to put it there, because we'll swap to our bricks first, and we're going to come one in on the black. We're just going to go 1, 2, button, and then we'll go a powered rail, followed by 7 regulars, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then a detector rail, 3 powered, and a detector, followed by 7 regulars. And we're just going to repeat that again. And we'll just keep doing that until you reach the other end of where you need to go. Because if you do that correctly, the detector rail should activate the power rails and keep pushing you along. So let's give it a try. Get out of flying mode. Ride. Use. Wee-ah. Wait, that's not how you exit. Right stick is exit. Aha! So again, now that I've shown you the basics on how to build that, I'm just going to take a quick pause here as I go through it and finish it off and build it all the way along there. And then we'll start on the ONI waiting room area. Hey, and I'm back. Not that that mattered for you guys. It was like a second anyway. So this is what you should be looking at right now as your final product. Just making sure that you do actually still have your glowstone or lights every so often and your train track in the middle. So, with that done, let's get on to building the ONI room. So what we're going to need is, we're still going to need some stone bricks. We're still going to need the stone slab. We're going to need the potion of swiftness, because where would I be without that? We'll need black wool, grey wool, light grey wool, whoops. White wool, and green. Well, lime green. Alright, so what we're going to do just to start off with is we're going to have our stone brick block out. And off the black wall, we're just going to do 5 off of that. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122 three, four, five. Now, I've gone in the center off the black for a reason. Because I'm going to swap back to my black. I'm going to place one there, and then four either side. So, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. That way, you should have a row of nine in total, which, well, I do anyway. From there, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in one, and then go out two, and then in one, and then out two, and then in one, out one, in one, out one, down two more, then out one, down two more, then out one, and down eight more. So one, we will have a row of nine here. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you should be looking at something like that. So you can see it is actually a symmetrical pattern. And we're just going to do the same on this side. So down one, out two, down one, out two, down one, out one, down one, out one, down two, out one, down two, out one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So like I said, you should be looking at a symmetrical pattern like that, because we're just going to make a big circle, so we're just going to keep doing that pattern all the way around, which means we're going to come in one, down two, in one, down two, in one, down one, in one, out one, across two more, out one, across two more, out one, and across eight more to make a row of nine. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And like I said, as you can see, it's still a circle, nice and symmetrical. So we're just going to finish this off real quick. I mean, I think you guys have got the gist of the pattern by now. So like I said, we're just making a circle, which we've made. Pretty simple and straightforward. So what we're going to do is we're going to come up to the top here where we started. And we're just going to add a second row of black in. Then we're going to swap to a light grey. Now, dead center here in the middle, we want to place one. Then we want to come down one, out one, smash that out, add another one. And then we want to go down one more, out one, smash that out. Because we want to do a diagonal line going down here like this. And it's going to be on a pattern like what we've done here. So it's going to be like just a single one, then a row of two, then a single one, then a row of two, then a single one, then a row of two. And we're just going to keep doing that until we reach the edge. Just like that. So that means we're going to do the same on this side, because we're building a triangle. Well, we're building the ONI symbol, so. So you should be looking at something a bit like that. So just to finish off the triangle, because it's not a perfect triangle, it's a bit of a slanty one. From this lot of one here that reaches the end, we're going to go to the black one, and we're going to come in three. Then we're just going to place another one temporarily, go to the bottom, smash that out, do another row of three, and we're going to do the same again, so another one there, with another row of three. And of course, what we do on one side, we do on the other. So it's just basically three rows of three on a going down angle. So you're looking at something like that. And then just in this gap here, whoops, we just want to place one single one there like so. Pretty easy, pretty straightforward. So what we're going to do now is we're going to swap to our black wool and off of this little one here that we just placed, we're going to come four to the top. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to swap to our white and we're just going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we're basically going to make like a plus sign here. Like that. But on each inside piece, we're just going to go boosh, 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 boosh. So we have a pattern sort of like that. Now we're going to swap back to our black wool. And with that, we're going to trace around the right-hand side here and then go straight up to the top. So, now here's the fun part. The left-hand side of the triangle can be filled in with black. The right can be filled in with white. So, let's do that now. God damn it. Ah, that's light gray. I want white. So that way you should have something like that as the finalized product. But in my world, I've actually got, smack bang in the middle here, I've actually got a redstone lamp. So I'll just put glowstone there for the time being. Now, before we finish off, we want to go to our grey wall. And up the top here of the ONI symbol, right where we've got this single one of light grey, we want to do two grey there like so. We then want to come down one, out two more, down one, out two more, then down one, out one, down one, out one, across, down two more, out one, down two more, out one, and then down seven, and that includes that one. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So where you should be looking at something like that as the pattern. And then this in here can actually be filled in with grey. And this part here can be filled in with black. And then we're going to do the same what we did on this side here, on that side there. So we'll swap back to our grey, and we'll go 1, 2, down 1, out 2, down 1, out 2, down 1, out 1, down 1, out 1, down two, out one, down two, out one, and we want a row of seven. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Alright, now down the bottom here, this is very easy. We're going to go back to our grey wall, and in this spot here where we have our first row of three, on the right hand side, we're just going to place one there, then a single row of three there, and then we're going to come down off that grey and do another row of cross, and then we want a row of five along the bottom, so that's one in the middle and two each side, and then we just repeat it, so one there, a row there, a row there, so you're looking at something like that, and then the rest just gets filled in with black. And that gives you the ONI logo. Heyo! Right, now we need to build the room around the logo. So what we're going to do is swap to a stone brick stab. Okay, slabs are stabbing, slabs be stabbing. We're going to swap to a stone brick slab, and what we're going to do is where we have this stone brick here below the glass, we want to actually go do a double stack of that, so it's like one, two, like so. We want to do three of them, like that. Now we want to go out one, down one, across two more. Then we want to go down one, across two more, then down one, across one, down one, across one, then down two, then out one, then down two, then out one, then down 10 more. So that way we have a row of 11, so we already have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I feel like I have missed one. So that should be, whoops, 3 out from... I did miss one. Bear with me for a second while I find the mistake. Let's have a quick pause. Aha! Turns out it is an easy fix. I missed a row of three. So just here, I've got one row of three down, two rows of three down, three rows of three down. Then it's the one of 11. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. See, that wasn't so bad. Alright, and then all we're going to do now is repeat what we've just done up there on the way back around. So, we want to come in one and down two, so we have a row of three. And we want to do that again. And again. So we have three rows of three. And then we want to come in one, down one, in one, down one, across two, down one, across two. So that should be one, two, three. One more. And then down. Two more. So, if you've done that correctly, this should line up with the cap here off that first row, which it does. Hey, I managed to do that correctly. So then what you can do from here is, with the black wall level, you can just fill in the floor with whatever you want. I use stone bricks because YOLO. Actually, you know what? I am going to brick underneath that. So that way you should be looking at something a little bit like this. I'm actually going to do across the top here as well, might as well. So you should be looking at something a bit like that. Now all you need to do from here is drink that potion of swiftness, swap to your lime green wool. And from this second block in, actually no bugger, we'll go from the first. We'll go from the first. All you're going to do with your lime green wool is just trace around your blocks or your slabs. And all you want to do is just one row through. It's just one row. Whoops. Like so, and then from there, we're going to swap back to our stone bricks, and we're going to do the same again, except this time, this one is going to be a block lower than the lime green, so there is a very good reason for this. Alright, so once we've got that, what we're then going to do is we're going to add another row tracing around of stone bricks, but this one is going to be at the same height as what the green wall was. Ah, I'm doing this to confuse yous. You're probably wondering, why are we doing this? This makes no sense. It is illogical. You're illogical. Yeah, that's right. I said that. And what we're going to do in that gap is we're going to go into our inventory, break out our water bucket, and we're just going to fill that whole thing with water. No! Come on, why can't we have cool water features in our places? Like so. We're going to ditch that. We'll ditch that, ditch that, ditch that. Because before we start building up, we'll grab grass block. Bugger, I might put oak trees in. You guys can put whatever you want. Give us some bone meal, because we want to put some trees in here, liven this place up a little. I mean, come on. It's ONI. When are ONI ever fun? Never, that's right. So, we'll just grow a tree. Hey. Where do I want the next one? might put one smack bang in the middle here. Grow, damn it! And what about there? That looks about halfway between the other two. And I like my stuff symmetrical, so one there. And where was the other one down? Oh no! I missed a spot with my water. I blame myself. Ah! Let me out. Alright, so now that that's done, we can actually start to build up air walls. So, we're going to drink a potion of swiftness, and from here, where we actually have this row that we've just done here that's holding the water in, that row can actually go all the way down to the ground, and underwater if you feel like it. And you can do that all the way around. I'm just doing this for a bit of demo, but you get the point. So I'm just going to stop there. But up the top here, we actually want to do a row of stone brick around, like just one level. And then from here, you can go into your inventory and break out a window. You can either break out like your regular glass or stained glass pane. It doesn't really matter which one you want. For this purpose, I believe I'm going to use, I reckon I might use yellow because I don't think I've used that yet. And then all you want to do is keep following this good old stone brick pattern around, and we want 5 rows of it high. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like I said, you just want to do this all the way around. So just to save a bit of time and effort here, because you guys kind of get the point by now, I'm going to have a quick pause while I finish this off, and I'm also going to do the other side of this. So the other side of that is just a mirror of this, so just, you know, replay the video again, or just copy what you've built over that side, over this side, and I'll be back in a jiffy. Okay, and I'm back. And as you can see, I've copied what I've done on the left-hand side over onto the right. Now we just need to add a roof and fix up a few little other things, and this video is done. So what we're going to fix up first is, in this gap here between the two sides, we're just going to swap to a stone brick, and we're just going to level it all up. And we're just going to do this right up to the edge. Like so. We'll leave that gap there because that won't need to worry or concern us next week. However, on the other side, there is a gap here. So what we can do is just smash out that bottom stair. Not the one that I did accidentally destroy. Water, we don't need you. And same on this side here. And then you can just do your stone bricks all the way across. So that way you just keep doing it keep doing it until you reach the ground level, or in my case, I just go a row into the water. So that fixes that up there. Now, as for up the top here where we have the stairs, what we do Ooh, I heard that. Is it just going to take out the top facing stairs? And again, we're just going to replace it with stone blocks. And again, we're just going to do that until we reach the top level. Like so. Then all we're going to do from here is we just want to add one row of stone bricks on top of the glass all the way around. Oops. Dang it. Dang it. Woo! And then from here, we're going to add a row of stairs all the way around. Just making sure that when you get to your corners, you curve them in. And around, and so on and so forth. I know that seems a little bit tricky sometimes, but hey, the end results are worth it. Well, they are, in my opinion, anyway. So much tedious moving back and forth, spinning round. Oh, just to make this look pretty. And the funny thing is, we're going to do this all again in a second. Hey! Because what we will do is we will actually add another row, except this row will be one higher, but one in. So that way you're looking at something like that, and then like I said, we want to add another row, that's one in and one higher, so boosh, boosh. And then while you're doing this, think of another stained glass colour, one that you like, doesn't bother me, because we're going to then fill in the roof with a stained glass of our choosing. I will be using regular blue. So I've already used light blue, used yellow. I've got lime green wool. I've got black wool, white wool, grey and light grey. So might as well lighten up the grey with some blue. That's if I can get these stairs done. So tedious, this back and forth. Up. Potion, no! Dope. Oh, come on, that's not even how I was facing. Come on. Hey, here we go. Alright, so now that that's done, let's clear the inventory and break out your stained glass. Like I said, I'm going to use blue, and then all you got to do is just fill it in. This is seriously it. But I think you guys need to see me do this part, so I'm just going to have another quick pause here while I just go from side to side, because it's probably going to take me a couple of minutes to do. So I'll have a quick pause and show you guys the finished result, and we'll end this video. Okay, and there we go. That's one roofed-in building. And that has it done for today's video. So if you do like this video, make sure you smack that like button, subscribe if you haven't, and tune in next week for when we finally start on that ONI Alpha base building that you guys have been wanting for so long. So until then, see you guys next week. Bye!